Hello everybody, hope you all are doing amazing. Welcome to my channel. This video is a part of my Christ Diaries and today I will be talking to you guys in depth about the certificate courses at Christ University. I'm sure not a lot of you people joining Christ University know about the certificate courses at Christ University. In this video, I've covered each and everything that you need to know about these certificate courses at Christ University. So make sure you watch this video till the very end. So now, let's get started. First and foremost thing, what are certificate courses? So certificate courses, or as they're popularly known in Christ University as CC or cert courses, are the courses which are in addition to your course curriculum and the course that you have joined at Christ University. The reason why they exist is for skill enhancement. If you want to gain another skill, then you can go for these particular courses. Then you can even do it for other domain knowledge, which means that if you're doing a course in law, but you also want to know about management or about accounts or about any other thing for which there is a course possible, you can choose that course so that you know about what is happening in another field as well. Thirdly, it is for minimum credit requirement. I will talk about that a little later in this video. But yes, you will also be doing certificate courses if there is a minimum credit requirement for that. Fourthly, it is for better future prospects. Like you would know, courses exist online, offline, and everywhere. And the people, when they do and choose a particular course, they majorly do it for better future prospects in terms of getting a job or just gaining skills and expertise in a particular area. So this is primarily the reason why certificate courses exist at Christ University. Now, who is it for? I've divided it into three main categories of the people for whom certificate courses are. Firstly, the mandatory course requirement. Like in the previous slide, I talked about the minimum course requirement. For a lot of courses, as per the UGC guideline, when you are graduating, you need to have minimum credits so that you can get a degree. But a lot of courses at Christ University, even while completing all the classes that you have done and completed the course which is in the curriculum, you might not be able to meet that minimum credit requirement. Hence, for those courses specifically, Christ University has made it mandatory for the students of those courses to complete a few courses before they graduate. Like for a lot of courses in Christ University, you would have the requirement of completing minimum 2 courses in a specified time, which means you have to take up certificate courses other than your normal course, that too for a minimum of 2 times in a specified time, which is usually in the first 2 years of you joining Christ University. So you would have to complete the courses once you are in Christ University so that you meet the mandatory requirement. The only option you have is that you are free to choose whenever you want to do it. Either you can do it in odd semester, which is 1, 3 and 5, or you can do it in the even semester, which is 2, 4 and 6. Secondly, certificate courses are also optional and open. For other courses for which certificate courses are not a mandatory requirement, students are still open to apply for these courses, and it is optional for them if they want to study a certificate courses along with their course curriculum which they are already studying at Christ University, which means that it is not mandatory but it is open and optional for all the other students. Like I was from BBA Honours and I know that in BBA Honours certificate courses are not mandatory at all, because we in our course curriculum we already have subjects which has very high credits, and hence the reason we don't need to do a compulsory certificate course. But still, students from my course are open to choose a particular certificate course just because if we want to do it, we can do it. Thirdly, there are also a lot of exceptions for the mandatory course requirement, which means that if you have served any Christ University body, then you will get an exception for one certificate course in that 1 year. What do I basically mean by that is that if you're volunteering for Christ University sports team or Christ University cultural team, or you're working and volunteering with SWO, which is Student Welfare Organization, and you continuously do it for 1 whole year, then you get an exception for completing the mandatory course requirement of a certificate course, because associating yourself with any of the university bodies will give you credits. Hence, you would not need to do a certificate course specifically to get those credits. So that is the exception that you would have in terms of mandatory course requirement. With regards to which course falls under the mandatory course requirement and which doesn't, you will already be briefed about it when you join the university, and within the first few days, your professors or your seniors will come and tell you that if a certificate course is compulsory for you or not and how you have to go about it. Coming to the kind of courses, I personally am a fan of the kind of certificate courses that Christ University offered. The list of the certificate courses is very, very long and very wide in terms of the aspects of studying and learning. I've divided it into four main categories. Firstly, there are a lot of non-academic courses that you guys can choose from, which means you can choose a certificate course in gardening, or you can choose a certificate course in yoga, which is great, like for your mental health and for a lot of other kind of learnings which you might not do while you're obviously busy studying and completing your courses at Christ University. Secondly, there are courses from your own department. Now, along with what you are already studying in your classes, you might want to take up certificate courses from your own department if you want to get into in-depth of a particular specialization of your field or a subject that you really are passionate about. So if I'm already studying management, which is through obviously BBA honors, and I want to learn a lot about human resources, then my department is already offering a certificate course in human resources, so I can take up that certificate course and know a lot more about that particular field. Thirdly, courses from other departments. So when you're studying from your own department, you have already chosen a field that you're going to be studying about. But at the same time, you might want to know about other fields that exist, and you might also develop a liking towards other fields. So you can take up courses offered by other departments as well. So if I'm in BBA honors, but I really like BHM, so I can take up their bartending course, which is offered by the department of BHM. Likewise, if somebody is from law and they want to learn management, they can also do that by taking up courses from the management department. So you are free and flexible to choose courses from other departments as well. Thirdly, courses from external collaboration. So what do I mean by that is that Christ University already has a lot of external collaborations with companies or tutors from outside of the university, which come in university to teach you, and you can do a particular certificate course from those collaborations as well. Like during my time, they had collaborations with organizations from outside, and they came in and taught a course on family business, or they even come in college and teach students for IAS. If they want to prepare for the IAS exams, then there are tutors from outside which come and specifically take classes for the IAS exam. Likewise, it is for CAT and for other kind of collaborations in financial and derivatives markets and things like that. So you can take up courses which are like a kind of collaboration which Christ University has with external organizations or mentors. So these are the kind of courses, the list of which is very, very long, that you can choose from. Now, you all might be wondering, what is the process to go about and apply for these courses? So what exactly happens is that there will be a list of courses which will be displayed on the university boards as well as on your student portal, the ID and the password of which will be given to you when you join Christ University. So you can look at and scroll through the list of courses. The courses offered in even semester are totally different from the courses offered in odd semesters. However, there are a few courses which are just the same both for even semester and odd semester. So you guys can plan accordingly. If you are passionate about some particular course which is in the even semester, so you can wait for semesters like 2, 4 and 6 to take up that course. If they are common, then you can just look according to your schedule which is the best time for you to take up a course. Secondly, there will be an online application form which is through your student portal itself. So you need to keep checking your student portal. They will tell you the open dates and the deadlines before which you can apply, and during which you would have to apply for the particular course that you want to do it. One pro tip advice that I would give you is that it fills up very, very fast. Like each and every course, since these are certificate courses, the seats are very, very limited, which is like maximum 60, 40 or 70. So And people applying are a lot because people from all the other departments' courses are free to apply for any of the courses. And the hot selling courses actually run out like the within the moments of them being released. So make sure you already keep it planned of when you want to apply and be on your student portal before the application forms open up and you quickly apply. The results of this, like I've told you, is on the seat availability basis, which is first come first serve. There are also a few courses for which they have a small little test, or in fact even teachers recommend if you should do that course or you should not. So all that knowledge will be given to you by your faculty members when you join the university. Majorly, all the courses are on first come first serve basis, hence you have to apply at the right time or else you might miss that course, or if it is a course which comes only in one particular semester, so you would have to wait for one whole year to do that kind of course. So make sure you've already decided and planned which course you want to do and you are up and about running when it comes to your online application form, so that you guys can quickly fill in the application form and get the seat that you require. Now, another advice that I would give to the people who fall under the mandatory course requirement is that sometimes even if you don't get a particular course of your choice, try doing course for which there's already a seat left, because since it is mandatory course requirement, usually people delay it for the last moment and that time all the seats just fill out very, very fast. So I would highly recommend that when you join the university, make sure you try doing a certificate course in the second semester itself, so that you guys know about how the certificate courses go, and then the other one course which is compulsory, then you can do it in your second year, either in the third semester or in the fourth semester. Since it is mandatory, so it is better you guys get done with it as soon as possible. Two important things that you need to know is that since these courses are other than your course curriculum, so the fees of these courses is separate, which means that it is not included in the fees that you're paying to Christ University for your particular course. The prices vary from course to course, and they can start from anywhere around 1000 rupees for a particular course and can go up as high as 40,000 rupees for a particular course. So you also have to look at the prices of a particular course before you choose that particular course. Secondly, course timings and durations. Firstly, in terms of duration, usually the courses are designed in such a manner that it is either 45 hours or 60 hours, and the timings vary, which can either be in the early in the morning before the classes start, which is before 9 a.m. But majority of the courses are after 4 p.m., which means after your whole day of classes are done is when you have to sit for your certificate courses. So if after 4 o'clock when your classes are done, then you would go to your certificate course classes and then sit for another hour for your certificate course classes. Usually these certificate course classes do not happen on each and every day. Either they are on the first 3 days of the week or they are alternate days. But then again, it depends from course to course. There are also courses such as the IAS training course, which happens on all the 5 days of the week. So there are courses like those that also exist. Coming to third very important part, there is a proper attendance for these certificate courses as well. You have to maintain a minimum of 85% of attendance. So do not think that it is just like you register for the course, you pay the money for the course and that's it, and at the end of your course you will get a certificate. No, it doesn't happen like that. You have to maintain a minimum of 85% of attendance to be eligible to get a certificate for this particular course and added it to your degree. Fourth and the last thing, there are proper mid-sems and end-sems for these courses as well. If you have chosen a course which is non-academic in nature, then obviously you would just have practicals, like because they would not have any written test for gardening, or you would not have any written test for bartending. So that would be practical based. But if you're choosing up a course which is very, very theoretical in nature, then obviously you would have mid-sems and end-sems for it. Another thing that you have to note is that the marks of these mid-sems and end-sems and the credits you get for a particular course, they will be added to your degree when you are graduating from Christ University. So make sure whenever you choose up a particular certificate course, you're very, very serious about it and have already planned your schedule according to it, so that you don't miss out on the attendance and give your 100% when it comes to your mid-sems or your end-sem exams for that particular course. Coming to my personal experience, like I told you guys that I did BBA honors, and for BBA honors, certificate courses are not mandatory at all, because we are already doing extra subjects from a lot of other courses, and a lot of our courses have like 4 credits per subject, which is very, very high. Like, I think that's the maximum a course can have. And usually a lot of other courses for their subjects, they just have credits of 1 or 2 per subject. But since we have 4 credits per subject, and we also have skill development classes designed in our own curriculum itself, so for us, it was not compulsory to do a certificate course. However, I still took up one certificate course in my second year. That course was offered through external collaborations, which means there were tutors from outside which came and taught for this certificate course. The fun fact was that I was in the BGR campus, but my course was being taught in the main campus. So on all alternate days of the week, in one semester of my second year, I used to travel from the BGR campus to the central campus to complete this course. This course was on quantitative aptitude, which means that they would prepare you for quantitative aptitude, for your logical reasoning, all those things that you have done for your CUET exams. And majorly it is like, you know, they just set the right basis for CAT preparation. So this was in the central campus. It was on the quantitative aptitude course, and it was in the second year. The price of this course was very, very high. It was around 35,000. That's about it for the certificate courses. I think I've given you guys all the important information that you need to know about these certificate courses at Christ University. Thank you so much for watching my video. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Comment below if you guys have any doubts, questions or queries with regards to if your course falls under the mandatory credit requirement or not. Don't worry about it. Your teachers and the faculty members at Christ University will let you know about it when you join that particular course. Do not forget to share this video with your friends who are already in Christ University or are joining Christ University. Lastly, do not forget to subscribe to my channel, because if you would do, I would get highly motivated to make more videos for you all. And do not forget to press the bell icon so that you get notifications whenever I upload any new video. Take care, bye-bye.